Yeah, I will talk about the Caviar project, and here especially about high dynamic range and in combination with white color gamut. So first of all, what is HDR and why use it, how to support HDR operation, and how to support HDR as well as SDR operation together. So first of all, what is HDR and why use it? So HDR is a larger range of brightness and a larger range of colors, which is defined by the white color gamut, is part basically of the same solution. So, and what it does, it produces images which are more close to reality, because SDR or standard dynamic range only deliver you quite a small contrast range compared to what you will find in the nature. So, and it has been agreed basically in the industry that from all the different UHD features, which includes higher pixel count, higher frame rate, and HDR, HDR deliver the largest improvement in the perceived image quality. So means for the customers at home, it is very likely the most important part of the whole UHD story. So for file-based productions, so the film productions, there are well-defined workflows how to produce HDR as well as SDR content in many different flavors by one workflow. But the problem is for live, for the typical sport productions and music shows or game shows or things like that, it is much more complicated, because HDR and SDR need to be developed at the same time, and there is no post-production workflow which allows you to do different trimmings to the signal later on. So, and typically HDR is the main production format, because it has the larger contrast range and the larger amount of colors, and it will be then down mapped into SDR or standard dynamic range somewhere in the workflow. So unfortunately, there is not just one HDR standard. There are multiple different standards. And the International Telecommunication Union, the ITU, has specified two different HDR standards for production and delivery. And one is HLG, or hybrid log gamma, and the other one is PQ, or also known as SMT standard 2084. Unfortunately, there are even more standards used sometimes for production. So SLOG3 is one of the solutions which are sometimes used for live productions. So means any converter solution needs to be able to handle multiple different HDR formats. So how to do HDR operation? First of all, you need to have an imager which is able to capture the large contrast range. And to do so, you need to have an imager which have a very low noise output signal and a large full well capacity, because the difference between the noise floor and the maximum capabilities of the imager to capture signals is defining the maximum contrast or the dynamic range which you can handle. So, and important is only also not only to capture the large contrast, but also to process it in the workflow. So you need to have a large bit depth from your imager output and throughout the production workflow. So the new 2/3-inch CMOS imager we call Titan deliver an improved sensitivity as well as a larger dynamic range compared to its predecessor. And the improvement is more than 6 dB or double in the sensitivity compared to the previous generation. A technical paper about the capabilities of that imager, mainly with a focus to the high speed capabilities, but also to HDR, has been given last year at the SMT 2020 conference. So for a live production workflow, there are multiple different solutions. With our current LDX 8X series cameras, we support a complete separate parallel workflow. This is shown here in the upper part of the image. This is a very flexible workflow, but it's time consuming. It needs a lot of resources. You need to have different operators for SDR and HDR. So it's a workflow which is maybe too complex for typical day-to-day use. So most of people prefer to have a workflow where HDR is produced and SDR is derived by conversion. The problem here is that if you use an external converter card, as we show here in the middle, which is always possible, you have a lot of hardware resources which need to be implemented in the workflow. Therefore, an integrated HDR-SDR down converter inside the camera system would be a great benefit. And this is something what we have developed as part of that project here. So a flexible HDR-SDR down mapper with highest performance is required. And the problem is that we need to be able to handle all the different standards which are supported by the camera, which are PQ, HLG, and SLOG3. But in addition, depending on the workflow, a scene-referred or display-referred conversion is required. In addition, depending on the workflow, different code value ranges are used. And not to forget, also the color, the white color gamut, the BT2020, need to be remapped into the 709 color space. And then the question is also how to do that one with the out of gamut colors. Do you need to do a hard clip or clipping? And then there are different user preferences which need to be included into the conversion process. Direct mapping versus inverse tone mapping, different white reference points need to be taken care of. And then potentially on the longer term, also a dynamic behavior will be required. Today, everything is done with static conversion, but at one point of time, we expect the market will request a dynamic behavior that all need to be implemented. So we developed as part of the project a very powerful integrated HDR-SDR down mapper, which can be configured in multiple different ways to always deliver a perfect result. And as we can see on the block diagram, it's a quite complex thing where HDR first of all will be converted into the linear domain. And inside the linear domain, we do first of all the mapping from HDR into SDR, and then we also do the down mapping from the white color gamut into the 709 color gamut. And then finally we apply the SDR settings such as a gamma, knee processing and things like that, and finally do a clip. So what is the result of that? So here we show some comparison we did lately. On the left side you see 2 times a UHD output with hybrid log gamma with BT2020 color gamut on the left side. The left image is from one of our traditional cameras. On the right is one of the new cameras using the internal down mapper. So the HDR signal have been aligned to look exactly the same. And if we now look on the right image, we see again the two camera outputs on the left, the traditional camera, on the right, the new camera. And the difference is on the left side, it's a full parallel processing with a lot of user input. And on the right side, you see the result from the integrated down mapper. And as you see, they look almost identical. This is for the contrast levels. And the same can be here seen for the colors. On the left side, a vectorscope display of the different colors, and on the right, a screenshot of the same test chart. And as you can see, the results are almost identical. We have done some final tweaking later on to even improve the quality. And as a final result, it can be stated they look identical, and nobody can even see a difference between the two different results, even so they are derived in a completely different way.